Another low volume and pretty much a quiet weekend for the most part. Bitcoin closed on Friday right around that $34,000 level, and it also closed on Sunday pretty much around the same price. Again, we've continued to get rejected here at that $35,000 area. And not only is that pushing us down, but now we also have this right here, a descending resistance that's also pushing us down. As you guys can see, now we've set up two lower highs in a row. So now we have another decision coming this week with this new symmetrical triangle that's been setting up here on the charts. This, in combination with the GBTC unlocking event, the biggest ever, means a lot of volatility possibly this week. Let's go ahead and dive into the charts and see what the possibilities are. Hey, what's up? Jay here, and welcome to Bitcoin Daily, bringing you guys the best tips, tutorials, and ideas to help you guys become profitable and successful investors. The goal of this channel is to empower you guys with the knowledge and resources to take you up to that next level. So if you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. Also, if you guys enjoy this video, please go ahead and smash that like button and drop a comment letting me know. Let's jump into today's video. All right, guys. So as you guys can see here on today's chart, basically the weekend, nothing really happened. We opened and closed basically around the same price. Today we went up as high as 34,688 and then quickly got rejected back down. So far, we're down about 3.33%. If you look here, the overall market, everything is pretty much in the red today. There's not really much that's green. And in the last 7 days, we're down about 2.5%. Fear and greed index is pretty much in the same spot, hasn't really moved too much. You'll see it's been around that 20 to 25 to 30 area for the past week or so. So you'll see on the monthly, we've pretty much been stuck here, kind of setting up a big symmetrical triangle, right? And that basically goes from the low, what's the low here? 28,000 to the high of 41,000. So that would set up potentially a move in around this much, right? So this is a 36% move. And this is actually, if you look at this, this is exactly the price that we've been talking about, that if we get a move out basically above 42,000, our price target, remember, we've been talking about our price target being 48,000. And when you put the breakout, the possible breakout here, which would occur, we're looking at the weekly, so that would be in around about a week or two, end of the month, that puts the price on a breakout to about $48,000. So that would definitely go with the move that we have set up that we've spoken about, right? Now, the same move, if we have the breakdown instead of the breakout, this could lead us all the way down to the bottom of this range. Remember that we've been talking about these ranges here, right? And we said that if we fall below 28,000, then we can possibly retest all the way down to $18,000 to $20,000. If we have a breakdown from the weekly chart here that's forming this kind of symmetrical triangle here, right? The breakdown would go right to our range, which is the bottom of this range down here, $18,000 to $20,000. And the break to the upside would take us to the top of this range, which is our target on a move up, which is around $48,000. So that's definitely something that we have to keep a close eye on during the next move basically, right? So zooming in here, now you can see why it's so important for Bitcoin to hold this level at 28,000. If we fall below 28,000, this is the potential of the drop that we could see right here. And that's a lot of space here. That's basically, we would go into a free fall down to 24, 20, and $18,000. Those are the potential targets on a move in that direction. Now, with a move to the upside, nothing has changed. The targets are the same. 35 is a key level if we want to get into this range. We continue to get rejected there. After 35, then our next target is 38. 40 and 42. If we break above 42, then you already know we have all of this right here that we can run up. If we cannot get above 42, Bitcoin is going to continue seeing bearish price movement and bearish case scenarios, where the possibility, as we already spoke about, is all the way down here. So on Friday's video, we told you guys that a good trade entry for a short term would be that if you saw the price go all the way up to 35,000 and it could not get over and it got rejected, that you can short it. So we didn't personally take that short, but if anybody took that short, you would definitely be in profit right now. And this is exactly what we're calling for that trade, because there's so much resistance here that it's having a lot of trouble right now getting up above this 35K area. So what this is kind of, you know, telling me is that it wants to go lower. Remember that this week we have the selling pressure from GBTC. So if we go lower, we could possibly test 32, which we're almost at already. We're at 32,000 right now. We could retest that $31,000 to $30,000 range and possibly even test this, the what we were using as a spring in the accumulation schematic, which is around that $28,000 range. Now, we do not want to see it go all the way down that low, because if we go that low, there's a big possibility of breaking below this strong support that we've been holding here for the last 2 months or so. And if we break below that, then all bets are off on bullish movements. We could pretty much confirm below 28 that we are definitely in a bearish, you know, market for the moment. And even below 42 right now, as long as we're below 42,000, things are looking very, very bearish for Bitcoin. So if we look at the accumulation schematic here for Bitcoin in the Wyckoff, you'll see that, you know, it's not really playing out the way that it's would be supposed to play out, right? Because in the phase C, we're supposed to be seeing higher lows all the way throughout, and higher highs. As you can see, basically everything played out until this part right here. After we hit the spring and the test and we set up the higher high and higher low, we've kind of been stuck here, kind of accumulating here, like if basically a move is coming. Now, the move can go in either direction because it's setting up like a symmetrical triangle right now. So symmetrical triangles are basically 50-50 shots in both directions. So they're not a high probability setup in either direction. You just gotta look for the break and enter it once it breaks either up or down. So we'll keep watching this, but for right now, it's kind of getting into that invalidation stage because it's not playing out, you know, to the T for the moment. So we'll reassess at the end of the week with this and see where we're at. Now, although Ethereum was looking very strong last week, this week so far, it's been looking very weak. Over the weekend, there was really no movement here. And today we've tested as low as $2,000, which is a strong support here. So hopefully we see a bounce here at 2,000. But like we said, if Bitcoin continues down, then you should expect Ethereum to also follow suit and continue down as well. That next support being around $1,800, and beyond that would be probably around $1,700, which has been the lowest since the drop here. Now, remember that Ethereum does have an upgrade coming up on August 4th is when it's estimated. So that this could make for a buying opportunity here for Ethereum if the prices continue down. I like Ethereum at 2000. I like Ethereum at 1800. So I'm setting it. I'm buying definitely at these levels. Now, for trade setups here with Bitcoin, basically we're doing the same thing that we're looking at on Friday. We need a break above 35K for any short-term long trade entries. And we want to take short entries at the same price, 35K. If we see that it cannot get above, or if it goes above and drops back down, then we want that short-term short entry on BTC and to take profits on the way down. Another trade that I'm looking to take, if we see a breakdown here on Bitcoin, then I'm possibly looking for a entry possibly below 32,000. Now remember that these are scalp trades, so we're going to be looking to take profits very quickly on these. And that's pretty much it, guys. Not much has changed. This week we are looking more bearish than bullish as far as what's on the charts and what's been developing here over the weekend and so far today. So we have to just continue watching this very closely and see where we go from here throughout the week. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to smash that like button. If you guys have any questions, drop it in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys are new to the channel and turn on the notification bell. That's it for today, guys. I will see you guys on the next video. As always, peace and love.